एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय क्लास. दिस इज महजबीन फातिमा, कॉमर्स लेक्चरर एट एलिजाबेथ हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज. सो टुडे इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर 11th चैप्टर इन कॉमर्स ऑफ फर्स्ट ईयर, दैट इज एमएनसीज, दैट इज मल्टीनेशनल कॉर्पोरेशंस. नाउ लेट्स बिगिन विद अवर चैप्टर. नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट ऑफ अवर चैप्टर. The economic liberalization across the globe has given rise to the wave of multinational corporations. So as we all know that due to economic liberalization across the globe or due to modernization across the globe, it has given rise to the multinational corporations. These multinational corporations are considered powerful drivers of globalization. They are considered as the powerful drivers. It is estimated that MNCs account for 2/3 of world trade. The role of multinationals in the world economy has continued to grow, as reflected by the expansion of foreign direct investment. There has been a rapid growth in MNCs after the World War II. So after World War II, there has been a rapid growth in these multinational corporations, we can say. And the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development estimates that there were about 37,000 transnational corporations in the world by the early 1990s, of which 33,500 were parent corporations based in the developed countries. So these were the estimates where about 37,000 transnational corporations in the world are there by the 1990s. And due to this globalization and rapid growing of economy, many MNCs are coming to India and operating their business in India. Few top MNCs which are operating in India include Microsoft, IBM, Nestle, Procter & Gamble, Coca-Cola, Pepsi Company, Citigroup, Sony Corporation, Hewlett-Packard, etc. So these are the names of few multinational corporations which are being operated in our country, that is India. Let's see the meaning and definition of MNCs. The term multinational is made out of two words. So this term has been taken out from the two words, that is multi and national. Hence, a multinational corporation company is an organization doing business in more than one country. In other words, it is an organization or enterprise carrying a business in not only the country where it is registered, but also in several other countries. So, we can say that these multinational corporations, they are not only working in a particular country, but they are working or operating in several other countries also. It may also be tagged as international corporation, global giant, and transnational corporations. So these multinational companies can also be called as international corporation, global giant, and transnational corporations. The multinational corporation is a business organization whose activities are located in two or more than two countries and is the organizational form that invites foreign direct investment. This form consists of a country location where the firm is incorporated and of the establishment of branches and subsidiaries in foreign countries. Multinational companies can obviously vary in extent of their multinational activities in terms of the number of countries in which they operate. A large multinational corporation can operate in 100 countries with hundreds of thousands of employees located outside its home country. So as we have discussed that these multinational corporations, they are not only operating in any particular country, but they are operating in different other countries also. So same likewise, like these companies, there are number of employees also, or thousands of employees also, who are located outside the country and they are working for these multinational corporations. Generally, the corporation has its headquarters in one country and operates wholly or partially owned subsidiaries in other countries. So these corporations, they are working in other countries wholly or partially. Its subsidiaries report to the corporation central headquarters. So some of Indian MNCs operating at global level. So in our country also, we are having some of the MNCs, that is multinational corporations, which are working globally or which are working at the global level, we can say. So they are Infosys, Wipro, and Reddy Labs, etc. So similarly, like Coca-Cola, Walmart, Toshiba, Honda, and BMW, IBM Computers, and Pepsi-Cola are from USA. So similarly, like our country is having this Infosys, Wipro, MNCs, same like us, other countries like USA is also having the other companies like Coca-Cola, Walmart, Nike, etc. Let's see what is the necessity of globalization. Globalization has become the buzzword that has changed the human lives around the world in a variety of ways. So globalization is the term that has changed human life in different types of ways, we can say. And this globalization is one of the most complex terms used in international business, has wide connotations, globalization refers to the free cross-border movement of goods, services, capital, information and people. So, actual term globalization meaning is, we can say that there is a free cross-border movement of goods, services, capital, information and people. And it can also be considered as the process of creating networks of connection among nations at multi-continental distances. It is the integration of the countries and people across the world. So this globalization is considered as the integration of the company and its people across the world. Therefore, we can define globalization as the process of integration and convergence of economic, financial, cultural and political system across the world. So there are some of the possible reasons which may be considered as important determinants of the globalization. Now let's have a glance at them. So the first one is economic liberalization. Economic liberalization, both in terms of regulations and tariff structure, has greatly contributed to the globalization of trade and investment. So here under this economic liberalization, it has contributed to the globalization of trade and investment in terms of regulations and tariff structure. And next one is technological breakthroughs. And the next one is technological breakthroughs. The breakthroughs in science and technology have transformed the world virtually into a globe village, especially manufacturing, transportation and information and communication technology. So this actually includes the transformation of science and technology in the world virtually into a globe village, especially it considered manufacturing, transportation and information and some communication technologies. And the next one is creates employment opportunities. So the name itself is indicating that this globalization helps in creating the employment opportunities. Now let's have a look at it. Globalization helps to provide employment to a large number of people. Multinational companies such as business process outsource, popularly known as call center employees, and appoint a large number of personnel with high pay scale and other benefits. So these multinational corporations are allowing the unemployment laborers So these multinational corporations are allowing the people of the country to work in their company as the employees, and they are also appointing a large number of persons, a large number of persons with high pay scale and other benefits. The next one is global expansion of business operations. Growing markets and movement of capital flows across the countries have facilitated the rapid expansion of business operations globally. So, as we already know that nothing can be done without the capital. So, here there is a rapid movement in capital across the countries, and this have facilitated the rapid expansion of business operations also. And these MNCs are being operated globally. And the next one is emergence of global consumer segment. Globalization encourages free and fair competition at world level. Due to this, organizations try to supply quality goods and at a reduced prices. Customers may have more choices due to increased suppliers at global level. So under this, we are having different types of MNCs which are providing different variety of products and quality of goods at a reduced prices or at the cheaper prices, we can say. So here the customers are having different choices due to the increased suppliers at the global level. And the last one is enhanced trade. Due to globalization, trade across the countries has enhanced and business organizations are enjoying the benefits of global access to the customers, resulting in enhanced revenues. So as we already know that customers, they have accepted this MNCs globally and they are enjoying the benefit of these MNCs and they are enjoying the benefits of these MNCs, and this trade has also enhanced across the country and with other countries as well. Now these multinational corporations are having distinctive features, and let's discuss about each of its feature. So the first one is large in size. A multinational company is generally big in size. Some of the multinational companies own and control assets worth billion of dollars. Their annual sales turnover is more than the gross national product of many small countries. So these multinational companies, they are generally operating in a big size, we can say, and some of these multinational companies, they own and control the assets which worth the billions of dollars, and their annual scale turnover will be more than the gross national product of different small countries. The next one is international operations. The multinational corporation carries on business is in more than one country. Multinational corporations such as Wipro, Colgate, Palmolive, कोको कोला हैव ब्रांचेस इन एज मेनी एज 70 कंट्रीज अक्रॉस द वर्ल्ड. सो देर आर सम ऑफ द मल्टीनेशनल कॉर्पोरेशंस विच आर वर्किंग ग्लोबली एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड. सो दीज कॉर्पोरेशंस आर कैरिंग द बिजनेस इन मोर देन वन कंट्रीज एंड देर आर सम ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ दोज कंट्रीज has been given, that is Wipro, Colgate, Palmolive, Coca-Cola. So these multinational corporations, they are having branches over many of the 70, over many as 70 countries around the world. The next one is international management. The management of multinational companies is international in character. It operates on the basis of best possible alternative available anywhere in the world. Its local subsidiaries are managed generally by the nationals of the host country. For example, the management of Hindustan Lever lies with Indians. The parent company Unilever is in the United States of America. So these multinational companies, they are managed by the host of that particular country. Here the example is given that management of Hindustan Lever will lies under the Indians, and same like that, the parent company of Unilever in the United States of America. The next one is centralized control. The branches of multinational companies spread in different countries are controlled and managed from the headquarters situated in the home country. All branches operate within the policy framework formed by the headquarters. So, as we already know that these multinational corporations are working globally and they are having different branches at different countries. So, here they all are spread across the different countries and controlled and managed from the headquarters. There will be headquarters which will be situated in the home country from where they will frame the policy framework, and those policy framework will be accepted by all the branches of that particular MNC. So, like this, they can manage and control their particular MNC, we can say. So, the next one is sophisticated technology. Multinational companies make use of latest and advanced technology to supply world-class products. They use capital-intensive technology and innovative techniques of production. So, these multinational companies, they are making the latest and advanced technology. So, due to this globalization, so these MNCs, they are operating with the advanced technology and they also supply world class products. They use the capital intensive technology and they are also using the innovative techniques in production. And the last one is several forms. A multinational company may operate in host countries in several ways. So in the host country, these multinational companies can be operated in several ways, we can say. So example is given like branches, subsidiary, franchise, joint ventures, turnkey projects. So these are the examples by which or in several ways these MNCs are operating. MNCs directly and indirectly help both home country and the host country. Various advantages of MNCs are explained. They are helping the host country and the home country directly or indirectly in several ways. Now let's see some of the advantages of these MNCs. So the first one is economic development. The developing countries need both foreign capital and technology to make use of available resources for economic and industrial growth. MNCs can provide the required financial, technical and other resources to the needy countries in exchange for economic gains. So as we know, we all are having different resources, but to utilize them properly in a correct manner, it is the main thing. So here these MNCs, they are in need of both foreign capital and technology to make use of the available resources. Whatever the available resources are there, they are making use of it and it's being used for economic and industrial growth. And these MNCs, they are providing the required financial, technical and other resources to the needy countries in exchange for economic gains. Next advantage is industrial growth. MNCs are dynamic and offer growth opportunities to domestic industries. MNCs assist local producers to enter the global markets through their well-established international network of production and marketing, and thereby ensure industrial growth. So these MNCs, they are also giving the growth opportunities for domestic industries. And MNCs, they also assist local producers and enter the global markets through their well-established international network of production and marketing, we can say, and thereby it also gives the opportunities for the industrial growth. And the next one is marketing opportunities. MNCs have access to many markets in different countries. They have the necessary skill and expertise to market products at international level. For example, an Indian company can enter into joint venture with the foreign country to sell its product in the international market. So these MNCs, they are also providing the access to many markets in different countries, and they are having all the necessary skill to expertise to market products at international level. So here the example is given that Indian company can enter into a joint venture with a foreign country, with a foreign company, where it sell its product at the international market. And the next advantage is work culture. MNCs introduce a work culture of excellence, professionalism and transparency in deals. So these MNCs, they are introducing the work culture of excellence, we can say, or professionalism, we can say, and they are also adding the transparency in deals. The primary objective of multinational company is to maximize the profit and increase the market share. So the main objective of this MNC is to maximize the company's profit and increase the market share. And in order to complete their goals, these MNCs, they are using the different strategies like innovations of product, technological upgradations, etc. So to achieve these goals, they are trying the innovative ideas or innovative methods, we can say. So this was all about our 11th chapter, that is multinational corporations. So in this chapter, we have seen the definition, necessity of globalization and the advantages of these multinational corporations. So I hope you all understood this chapter very well. Let's continue our next chapter in next class. Thank you.